natural unalloyed mental ability one can approach the plants. Second thing is morale, the principle and way of life. You know that Jay Krishnamurti, he has written in his autobiography, wherever there is a garden where a carpus plant, it is not giving the carpeti, that is the fruit, wherever the flowers are not properly there, envisioned in flowering, that is crops or plants or shrubs or herbs, wherever those things are stagnated, wherever those things are totally withered off, wherever those things are non-productive in any part, either in growth or giving flowers or fruits or vegetative growth and vegetative mushity, there Krishnamurti is properly invited by his friends. And whenever he touches and feels and internally communicates with those systems, immediately they have personally experimented as well as experienced that they started growing, they started giving fruit, they started flowering, they started budding, they started developing the leaves, they started germinating. So all the other various things, apart from a natural process of agronomy, it is a process of psychoagronomy in which the mind and the pure and potential impulses of the mind, that also negotiates with the nature. But we may ask a question, there are 100 acres of paddy farm. How long it will take for me to communicate with each and every paddy, and how long I can develop some sort of system? It is mass communication. You are studying MA mass communication. Even if it is 1000 acres, even if it is 10,000 acres, even if it is a wide single globe, Mother Earth, we can communicate. Sarve jana sukhino bhavantu. Urdhvam jikatu bheshajam. You can communicate with any number of elements, at any number of acres, on any number of vegetative heterogeneity in mixed farming, or even placement farming, or poly farming, or whatever may be the structure, you can communicate with anything. That is mind. And music and mantra, these are the special representations of the same mind. A beautiful mind is itself a music. If your mind is beautiful, then it is music. If your mind is powerful, that is mantra. That's what Tolhapier, he says, mantra is nothing but the potency that is orally revealed by a capable, sturdy person. Any person who is principally, practically sturdy in his nature, and that potency that is orally revealed is known as a mantra. So, the beauty of the mind is music, and the efficacy of the mind is mantra. And the placid mind consists of overall affection, which caters for all-round happiness. And morale is governance of the principles in the surroundings. So, apart from the various other engineering process, we must develop a type of engineering which is psycho-engineering, which is phono-engineering, and which is ethical engineering, by which we can create the really trouble-free world, wherein by whatever you are facing, obscurity, obtuseness, long-term unassured benefits, immediate side effects, we get all effects. After effect, before effect, side effect, upper effect, lower effect, except the desired effect, we get all the other effects. To get the desired long-term, primeval, perennial and perpetual cycle of benefits to all of the people, we must know how to intrude with ethics, that is ethical engineering, how to intrude with an eco-balance, that is eco-engineering, how to deal with our melody and potency by mantra and music, that is phono-engineering. Certainly we have to make new courses, at least for the believers, the so-called astikas. There are more than 80% astikas who are just candid astikas. Candid religious people are 80%. 15% of the people, they are clandestine theists inside, and the 5% of the people, they are shuffling between these two centers. So lot of people, they are believing mantra, they are believing music, they are believing ethics. While coming to the practical view, they are overruled by uncontrolled emotions or their needs in the form of greed and violence, due to which they used to go for something which is not their true nature at all. So this genuinity encroachment is due to their aberration from the arbitrary fixation of Acharya Parampara and Deva Parampara or Upasana Parampara. So either they must surrender to somebody, or somebody else should embrace them so tenaciously clutched grip that they will not go, and they will not be aberrant from the orbital axis of religiosity, morality and ethicism. So this is how we have to create the world, and which this is the India Century Mission. We have to teach them eco-engineering, phono-engineering and the engineering which I have already explained now. So coming to this final point, I believe that sthavaras, unless, yesterday I told, if you plant a sthavara, that is equal to construction of a temple, that is included in Ishtapurta. construction of a temple, making Ashwamedha Yaga, Bhudana, Godana, Swarnadhana, all of these things are there in Vrikshasthapana. Likewise, Vrikshacheda, yesterday I told, Vrikshacheda is equal to Gohati, Pashuhati, Strihati, etc. So we consider that planting a plant is as auspicious as constructing a temple. And killing or uprooting a plant is as heinous as killing a cow or killing one's own mother or killing a woman or something else. So we have to understand this ethics of our life. And road expansion, habitation, other unwanted things are there, and wanted things are there in the society, wherein by planting of trees as well as taking them, dismantling the trees or crushing the trees are unavoidable in the expansion of population. So there must be a simultaneous governance. Wherever we used to deroot some plants or trees, simultaneously we have to develop social forests, herbal parks, etc. So I believe that we can take the initiative of developing this fauno, eco and ethical engineering through our traditional system for the real welfare of the mankind at large. Narayan, Narayan, Narayan.